Only the spirit of the Million Man March made his day of atonement forever touch your hearts. Remember the promises you made each other, my brother. Long live the spirit of the Million Man March. I had to go and see it for myself. I didn't want the beauty of this day told to me by anyone else. And as I stood on the grounds of D.C., I witnessed a million strong black men marching in unity.
Yeah.
I tell you, it was a million strong black men standing in unity. Yeah. Long live the spirit of the Million Man March. May this day of atonement forever touch your heart. Remember the promises you made each other, my brothers. Long live the spirit of the Million Man March. Now many said it just couldn't be done, and some even questioned the reason why God would use Farrakhan. But those who answered knew that the call was right, and it was the will of God and not man that had to be done. I tell you, it was the will of God and not man that had to be done.
Coming into the program, one of our freedom fighters, coming from Washington, D.C., but wherever there's a matter of young black men, young black women with their freedoms being offended, he's quick to take dollars out of his own pocket and go and to help. He is the founder of the Black Lawyers of Justice. He's also the attorney and the president and the head of the new Black Panther Party. Brothers and sisters, please help me to bring to the podium his attorney, Malik Zulu.
Assalamu alaikum. Black power.
Black power.
Free the land.
Free the land.
And black laws for all black people.
And black laws for all black people.
Given honor to God, I bear witness that regardless to land, label, or language, that there is but one God. I also bear witness that there's only one black man that could have brought 2 million black men to Washington 18 years ago, and that can pack this square today, wall to wall. And that man's name is the Honorable Louis Farrakhan. 18 years after the Million Man March, too many black men are taking guilty pleas. Too many black men are talking too much and making confessions when they don't have to. 18 years later, you are being stopped and searched and seized and beaten and killed by the police. And that time has to come to an end. And it comes to an end with knowledge. Hosea 4:6 say, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge, and because thou have rejected knowledge, I have rejected thee. And so I thank all of you all who have picked up my new booklet for the black nation called What Black People Know When Dealing With the Police. You gotta have a guide to deal with the police. Moving quickly, let me say this. Genesis in the 15th chapter, 13th verse says, thy seed, talking to Abram, God says, thy seed will be a stranger in a land that is not their own. And they shall serve them and be afflicted by them for 400 years. And God says, that nation who they serve, I will judge. We have a whole courtroom, a whole courthouse square full of witnesses, and the jury is present. I ask you, has America enslaved the black man?
Yes.
Has America falsely imprisoned black people?
Guilty.
Has America kidnapped black people?
Guilty.
Has America robbed us?
Yes.
America committed wrongful death upon millions and millions of us is the blood on the hands of the United States government.
Yes.
Does America owe us reparations?
Yes.
Does she owe us reparations?
Yes.
Well, the question is, who is the judge in this hour? And who is the judge of the judge? Now, I've been in many a courtroom and I've been forced to call many judges, Your Honor, and some of their honor was questionable.
Mayor Johnny Ford,
I'm here to tell you that my heart is happy today.
Yes, sir.
That Minister Farrakhan called me and he said what I know was from his heart. That if it had been physically possible for him to be here today, he would be here. But I said to him, Minister, take care of this day and your body and your health so that the Lord, so that our Lord will be able to enable you to live many other days and continue to serve as the leader of the nation. But we have work to do. And so it is my honor to invite the nation and the world to Tuskegee, Alabama.
Yeah.
Tuskegee. Tuskegee, the home of the flying, fighting, fearless Tuskegee Airmen.
Yeah.
Tuskegee, the home of the mother of the civil rights movement, Mrs. Rosa Parks, who sat down in Montgomery, Alabama, but was standing up for freedom everywhere.
Yeah.
The birthplace of Mrs. Rosa Parks, Tuskegee.
All right.
Tuskegee, the land of Dr. Booker T. Washington.
Yeah.
Who said to our people, cast down your buckets where you are. Tuskegee, the land of Dr. George Washington Carver, who took the peanut and the sweet potato and the soybean and revolutionized the agriculture economy of this whole nation and the world. Tuskegee, the home of Tuskegee University, the pride of the swift-growing South. Today, history is being made. In 1984, as president of the National Conference of Black Mayors, when I invited the Honorable Louis Farrakhan to come and speak, they threatened to put us out of the hotel. I said, that's all right. If you put us out of the hotel, we'll have our convention on the street. But Louis Farrakhan, his honor is going to come and speak to the National Conference of Black Mayors. And as black mayors and as black elected officials today, we recommit ourselves to work with the Nation of Islam. Because of the Million Man March, which was held 18 years ago, not only did they march that day, but they accepted the commitment and they went back and they got registered to vote. And more than 8 million new registered voters, black people all over America, got registered to vote, and they helped to change the political landscape of the United States of America. Those Republicans who shut down the government 18 years ago, many of them were swept out of office. And I know, brothers and sisters, this is not a political meeting. But I want to say to you that we need to get registered and vote so that we can make some changes in Washington, D.C. President Barack Obama needs our support, and I'm not ashamed to say that. We have come today on this holy day of atonement. We have come on the 18th anniversary of the Million Man March to say to America and to the world that we are not going to turn around.
All right, all right.
To say to the world that we are not satisfied.
All right.
We as black people, we don't need to worry about those folks on the motorcycles or those folks who are complaining, because we are killing each other. We've got to stop killing each other and love each other as black people in this country. We've got to stop the flow of drugs in our community. We've got to encourage our young people to not only finish high school, but go on to college. And that's why it was so important to have these black college students here this weekend. We have got to not be ashamed of being children of the soil, coming from the farms. We need to take back the farmed land. We need to cultivate the land, grow crops so that we can feed our children, feed the nation and the world. These are the ideas that Minister Farrakhan fights for and stands for. That's why we are together. I want you to know today that you are looking at a new beginning.
Come on.
You are seeing history being made. For Minister Farrakhan said to me on the phone today, he said that if I drop dead today, I want the nation and the world to know that the nation of Islam is not dead. It is alive because it has young brothers and sisters in my family and others who will carry on this work. And the nation, you need to know that black men, black judges, black lawyers, blacks in government, black school board members, black members of Congress, black county officials, black city officials, we have joined with the nation as one.
I'm here today because of the love of one man. I would have no purpose for my life and nothing to share with you today if it were not for that man, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. I thank Allah for this divine leader, teacher, guide, and warner to the nations of the earth. And it is in their names that I greet you with the greeting words of peace. Assalamu alaikum. We heard from his daughter, Sister Donna Farrakhan, of what he was affected with. And one of the things, dear brothers and sisters, that characterizes Minister Farrakhan and makes him a little different than others is he believes he is born to serve the people. He is a true public servant. Today, we will prove to ourselves that Allah is God, and besides him there is no other God. We will prove today the omnipotent, omnipresence of a God. We will prove today that God is always among us, always walking with us, ever a watcher over you and me. And if we believe in him and believe in the word that he has revealed and resolve in our hearts and minds that we will carry into practice the word that God has revealed, then we will go away from Tuskegee this afternoon to bear the fruit of a message that comes from God through an honorable and noble servant, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. We are here on this principle where there are two or more in my name. I am in the midst of thee. By the looks of it, there's more than two of us here.
That's right, that's right.
So surely the Lord is with us, and surely the Lord is present.
Long live the spirit of the million dimensions.